One of my favorite times of the year is the springtime. This is when you see lilies blooming all over the place. And it's such a beautiful reminder that out of that which may have appeared to be barren can come something beautiful. This week we are exploring the topic of growing in Christ. And today we are turning to a passage of scripture that teaches us about the lilies of the field. There's a reference found in Luke chapter 12, verse 27. For today, we are going to be looking at Matthew chapter 6, verses 28 and 29. Here is what the Bible says. So why do you worry about clothing? Consider the lilies of the field, how they grow. They neither toil nor spin, and yet I say to you that even Solomon in all his glory was not arrayed like one of these. Jesus here on the Sermon on the Mount, as he was speaking to a multitude of individuals who'd gathered to hear what he had to say, included in his discourse a discussion on the lilies of the field. Now, in those times, the lilies that were referred to here were most likely a perennial plant that would normally spring up in the springtime, and it was a wild flower. But nonetheless, it was beautiful and captivating in its presentation. And Jesus, standing nearby, would have looked at these beautiful plants and these flowers and say, consider these lilies. In other words, he wanted his listeners to stop and contemplate for a moment the beauty that was found in that delicate plant and try to unearth what it was about its principles of growth that caused it to be beautiful in its time. And that's the principle we want to uncover today. God makes all things beautiful in its time. The lily does not bloom all year round. It is normally budding and blooming in the springtime. This teaches the importance of seasons in our lives. There are seasons where we will see beauty and lots of progress, but there are other seasons where the petals of what we would normally put value on will fade and fall. And we are not to lose hope. My dear friends, it is customary that we often worry about the things that we can see, but we also tend to worry about the things we cannot see. And Jesus is calling our attention from the things that we tend to look for to now understanding more deeply and fundamentally the principles that we ought to live by. When we deconstruct the life and the composition of a lily, we understand that a lily grows from a bulb, It is a root, a part of the root system of the lily. It's a bulb. And when that bulb is planted, sometimes during the fall, it's planted in the ground, that bulb remains dormant. But in that bulb is the code for life and success and fruitfulness and flowers. In that bulb is the code. And so as long as the bulb remains in the ground below the frost line where it's supposed to be, even though it may be dormant, there is life and potential in that lily. At the appointed time, in the springtime, when the frost is gone and the ice is gone and the ground thaws and the warmth of the sun activates this code in the bulb of the lily, then it begins to shoot up these saplings that come and break the surface of the ground. And then as it unfolds, we can see it now in our mind's eye. The lily, the plant breaks the ground, the leaves unfold, and then out comes the stem, and now the flower blooms. And so it is with our lives, my dear friends. If we would nurture the bulb, the thing that we don't often see that lies beneath the surface, if we would cultivate a heart of sensitivity towards God, a desire, a longing to know Him more, then we don't have to worry about when we bloom or how colorful our petals are. We just need to know that our bulb is alive, that it contains the code for life. And where can we find this code? We find it in His Word. This is why Jesus emphasized this to those sitting on the Galilean hillside on that day. He says, consider the lily of the field. I would say, my dear friend, consider the lily of your heart, the lily of your life, your whole potential, your outlook. All that you're able to do and capable of doing is wrapped up in the bulb of your heart. And the Bible says we are to keep the heart with all diligence, for out of it are the issues of life. You are to make sure that your heart is safeguarded, that it is nurtured, and that it is buried beneath the surface of the ground, below the frost line, where it can find rest. And it can find safety, and that safety is found in the Lord Jesus Christ. Too many people are careless and casual about the bulb of their lives. They leave it strewn all over the surface of the ground where it's exposed to the elements, the heat, the cold, the frost, everything for people to trample upon. No, don't let anyone trample upon the bulb of your heart. Hide it safe in the soil where the Lord wants it, where He can nurture it, where He can keep it and cultivate it. And I promise you, my friend, when the appointed time comes, when the springtime of your life experience comes, that bulb will send out its shoots and you will see beautiful petals, delicate and lovely to behold. Here is another principle we grab as we consider the lily. The petals are beautiful, but they are delicate. In other words, those petals are so delicate that if you rub against them too forcefully, you could break them, you could bruise them. And so it is with our lives. We are petals in the hands of God. We are delicate. He safeguards us. If we choose to go outside of His care, we could be bruised. We could be broken. We could be violated. And God says we are to safeguard this plant. Another parallel or application of the lily I find, which is so powerful, is the brevity of life. We are like those lilies. We've come from the bulb and we've bloomed. And in the morning, we're bright and glorious. But then as the season goes on, a few days or weeks, the petals begin to fade and wrinkle. And then they begin to fade and brown. And soon they droop. And soon they fall. And soon they die. So it is with us. Our lives are short. But if we have cultivated a life of steadfastness by preserving the bulb, we know that there will come life again. For God says that He will bring with Him those who fall asleep in Christ Jesus. The beautiful thing about the bulb of the lily is that it doesn't just remain single. But if that bulb is properly planted and nurtured and nourished, it will produce other bulbs. So one becomes five, five become 20, 20 become 100. It proliferates. If we allow ourselves to be planted by the Lord, my dear friends, we too will spawn saplings and offspring who will bloom to the honor and glory of God. So today, consider the lily of the field, how they grow. Are you a lily today planted by the Lord? It is my prayer that we will seek Him and know Him, that we too will experience the perennial life that comes from knowing the Lord. and that we will see generations that follow who can say, I am who I am because you were faithful to the call. Let us pray. Father, I thank you today that we can learn from the lilies of the field. Yes, they do not toil, they do not spin, but even Solomon in all his glory was not arrayed like one of these. And we know that we are lilies in your field. Teach us, God, to appreciate your planting. Teach us to nurture the bulb of our hearts. Teach us not to be casual or careless, but to seek to bring forth the best by placing and allowing ourselves to be placed by you where we may flourish and grow. When there is beauty, may we give you all the praise, the honor, and the glory. And may we also appreciate the brevity of life and be diligent about making sure that the generations that spawn from our bulbs, from our bloodline, that they know who you are and that they also appreciate what you will do in their lives. Lord, make this our experience and reality. We thank you that you are the one that gives the results. And here we are, surrendering and yielding ourselves to your care and keeping. Cause us, God, to grow, and cause us to be beautiful in your sight, we pray. In Jesus' name, amen.